Hey everyone, this is Jyotika and welcome to your 19th HTML5 tutorial. Today, let's talk about including a form on your website. But before we jump into today's lesson, if you find the video helpful, then don't forget to show your support by liking it and subscribing to my channel. So, web forms are one of the main points of interaction between a user and a website or an app. We log into sites through forms, we buy things through forms, or even add content like reviews or comments to a site with the help of forms. The main purpose of forms is to allow a user to submit some information to a website for some specific purpose. In HTML, a form is created using different types of semantic form elements and not through the very generic div or span elements. These HTML form elements are very powerful, and all their complex functionality is already built in our browsers. So let's jump in and create a simple sign-up form. But before you even start to code, you might want to make a rough sketch of what you want in your form. This way you have a clear idea of where to put the different form elements. So here we want to collect two fields, the user's name and their email address. And then we also have a sign-up button below. To create a form, we will start by using the form element. It tells the browser that there is a form here. It has an opening and a closing tag. If you look in the browser, then it doesn't display anything as of yet. And that's because the form element is a container element just like a table, section, or a footer element. It is a holding place for all other form elements. Now let's make the two fields in our signup form, name and email. We don't keep these hanging just like that in the form. We have to put them inside some element. So we'll make these form elements into labels by using the label element. Then we want to add the actual places or boxes where someone will type their name and email. And we do that with the input element. It specifies an input field where the user can enter data. It is an empty element, meaning it does not have any content or closing tag. But it is the most important element in a form. This is where all the magic happens. The browser puts a whole lot of complex functionality in this tiny little box. Now, although it looks fine, the input field is not yet complete. Each input field must have a name attribute for the form to be submitted to the server. If the name attribute is omitted, the value that is written in the input field will not be sent at all. Well, we are not going to actually send anything in this tutorial. It is all backend stuff which you will learn later if you decide to study backend development. But for now, let's just understand that this name attribute is very important for all the form elements. So let's add name equals name to the first input element and name equals email to the second. We can call this whatever name we want, name equals first name or whatever we want. Next, we also need a button on our form that people can click to submit the form. For that, we are going to use the button element. It has both an opening and closing tag. And whatever words we put as content in between the tags are the words that will display on the button itself. Let's write sign up here. If you look in the browser, we now have a simple sign up button in our form. Also, right now the form looks kinda ugly, but the styling can be easily changed later using CSS. In this tutorial, we are going to focus only on HTML. Now let's see what this button does. Let's type something in these input fields and then click the button. Well, right now the button doesn't do anything. It doesn't submit our form anywhere because we haven't added any backend code. But again, we are just going to focus on the HTML part in this tutorial. Now, if you see the code, the label element and the input element are just sitting next to each other. They aren't actually connected to each other. People who do not use the web traditionally like we do with a screen that they can see or a mouse to click on an input field will not know that this label goes with this input. So in order to connect them, we have two options. First, we can add a for attribute to the label and an ID attribute to the input with a matching name. Let's say for equals email on the label and ID equals email on the input. We can also call this whatever we want as long as the two names are the same. Or the second option, we could wrap the label around the entire input element, which clearly communicates to the browser that this label is for this input field. Both options work the same. To test if they are actually connected, we can go back to our web page and click on the label. See how when I click on the label, my cursor automatically shows up in the input box and there's a focus state or a blue ring around it? That's what we want. Next, I want to bring your attention to another problem in our form. When I type inside these two input fields, I can type anything I want and the form will accept it. But we want people to type an email in this field and not just any text. So how can we fix that? Well, for that, we use the type attribute in each of the input elements. For the name field, we will collect text, which is the default type of the input element. If you don't write any type attribute here for the name input element, the browser will assume that it's the type equals text. So we don't have to include it. But as a good practice and for completion's sake, let's write type equals text. Then for the email input, type equals email. Now let's go ahead and test this. So a name here and some text here and hit sign up. So you can see a warning immediately popped up here asking us to type an email address. That's awesome. By writing just the correct type attribute inside the input element, we are getting validation for free from the browser. Now, we also want the browser to know that this button on the page is a button to submit all our info. We might have multiple buttons on this form later, and we want to let the browser know which button to activate when a user hits the return key or the enter key on their keyboard. Because sometimes people use the return key to submit instead of using a mouse to click the submit button. So we will just write type equals submit for this button element. There's another way that you can make a submit button. Instead of using the button element, you can use the input element. And the type attribute here will be submit. Name, as usual, anything you want. Let's just write submit. And then the actual text that will be seen on the button will be written inside a value attribute. So let's write submit here. And you can see in the browser, we have this other button and it works exactly like the earlier one. Next, we can further enhance our form by making any of the input fields compulsory before submitting the form. Right now, the browser seems to be accepting the form even if we type only one of the fields. So to make a particular field compulsory, we can add the required attribute in its input element. Just the word required. Now if I try to submit the form without filling out the email, you can see the browser is insisting that I fill out the email field by showing me a warning pop-up. It won't let me submit the form without filling the required field. Lastly, let's look at including some placeholder or a default value in our input boxes. It is like a suggestion to our form users of what should go into that particular input field. To do that, we use the placeholder attribute. And inside the quotes, we type in the suggestion that we want the users to see in the input box. You can see that now the suggested text appears in the box. It's light gray by default, and as soon as I start typing into this field, the placeholder disappears. That's important. Users should not have to keep erasing the placeholder text in order to write their own email addresses or other data. But if you in fact wanted to pre-populate the input field with real content, instead of just a suggestion like you see with many forms nowadays that autocomplete with the user's name, address, credit card numbers, then you must use a value attribute instead of the placeholder attribute. So now if I click in this input field to type my own email address, the pre-populated one is in the way. I have to manually erase it to put in my own. It doesn't disappear like the placeholder. And that's because the placeholder is just a suggestion, whereas the value is real data. So if I were to submit this form with a placeholder and a value attribute on two different inputs, then the input which has the value will be the only data that will get submitted with the form after clicking the submit button. The placeholder does not go through. It's basically nothing in that input. And that's it. These are the few of the many parts of a form. Right now what we have is just a basic form. But there is much more to forms than just text and email. In the next tutorial, we are going to create an advanced form by learning about the many other input types like passwords, phone numbers, checkboxes, and also various other interesting form elements. I will be putting a link to today's code and other informative links in the description below, so don't forget to check them out. Also, let me know in the comments if you have any questions. And if you haven't yet, do subscribe to the channel. This is Jyotika signing off. Until next time, keep learning and keep coding.